Hi, I'm Patrick Anderson, and this is the Mach-E vlog. Recently, I got a chance to take a look at the F-150 Lightning and the Ford E-Transit. Come along with me and let's take a look at both of these exciting new electric vehicles from Ford. Apparently, Ford is taking the F-150 Lightning and the E-Transit around the U.S. and doing like presentations and tours with these vehicles. The one that I went to was here in Denver, Colorado. They have more scheduled throughout the U.S. I just checked and it looks like they're all full. They're all completely reserved for slots. But I'll go ahead and put a link in the description if you want to check out the website and see if there are any new upcoming cities that you can take a look at these vehicles. The event that I went to was held in the parking lot of a soccer stadium here in Denver, Colorado. It was attended by people like me, as well as fleet managers, you know, local businesses that have like fleets of vehicles, as well as some police officers or police or law enforcement representatives that I guess were interested in either vehicle. They started us off with just a brief presentation about both the F-150 Lightning and the E-Transit, as well as, you know, for the fleet managers, some of the features that are going to be coming to them to manage these electric vehicles. For example, you'll be able to instantly sort of like monitor the charge status of all of the vehicles in your fleet, as well as manage the charging costs. So if your fleet people have to, you know, go and charge at a public charging station, it'll automatically like bill one centrally, you know, central account. If they are charging at home, so like if they take their vehicle home overnight and they're charging there, the management system can monitor how much energy they're using to charge the vehicle, the company vehicle, and then it will help you like automatically reimburse those people for their at-home charging costs. So some really cool fleet management stuff that they talked about. Another thing was is that they will be able to connect to the vehicle and monitor the drivers of each vehicle. So it can monitor and like let you know how many people are accelerating fast or braking really hard. And they actually gave us a demo of that in the drive and showed that not only will it report back to the management software, but the Ford Sync will speak to the driver and say, hey, that was a hard brake. You probably shouldn't do that unless it's an emergency. Of course, we were really there to see both of these EVs. And of course, most of us are excited about the F-150 Lightning because there will be a consumer version of that. When we went over to the area, we started off, we looked at the chassis of the F-150 that they had on display. They showed, you know, like where the battery pack is going to be. And just like with the Mach-E that I own, the battery pack will be underneath the floor of the vehicle, basically from the front wheels to the back wheels. Another thing that they emphasize is because of the weight of the batteries and where the battery will be placed in the truck, it'll keep the low center of gravity just as it is with the Mach-E, so that will help handling as well. The F-150 Lightning is going to come in two configurations. It'll either be a standard range or extended range. The standard range will get 230 miles of range, and the extended range will go up to about 300 miles of range. And one of the things to note about that is with stuff in the truck bed. I think they said it'd be about 1,000 pounds of payload in the truck bed that they are shooting for to still get that 300 miles of range. You can tow with the F-150 Lightning. Of course, that'll affect the range. You know, depending on which model you pick, you can get up to 10,000 pounds of towing out of the F-150 Lightning. So that's pretty cool. There are some other differences between the standard and extended range. You can see here the horsepower in the standard range is 426 horsepower versus the extended range, which is 563. Torque is the same at 775. And the onboard charger power you can see here is different for both of the models. One of the cool features that I'm looking forward to is the Mega Power Frunk on the F-150 Lightning. This thing looks huge, and it actually is. Like when you see it in person, it just looks massive. Of course, there's power built into the Power Frunk, or Mega Power Frunk, I should say. And there's a drain in there. So just like with the Mach-E, you can put some ice in there and just let it drain out. They did mention that you can wash out the Mega Power Frunk, but you don't want to use like a high power washer, like a power wash, because of those power outlets. You don't want to get water in there, but hosing it down should be no problem. In the rear of the truck, there's more and more power, of course, as well as the famous, you know, Ford tailgate that serves as like a workbench with all sorts of things that make Ford trucks like very useful and very handy on the work site. They did not demo this, but the taillights on the F-150 Lightning will be able to have a LED like load meter so that as you're loading up the bed of the truck, it will increase the light so that you know when you're nearing capacity of the truck bed. That's a cool feature that's available on the regular F-150 and will be brought over to the F-150 Lightning as well. We then moved over to the E-Transit, and of course there probably isn't as much excitement over the E-Transit because it's just like a work vehicle and people aren't just buying these by the millions like they are with the F-150. But Ford is very excited about this, and it's actually really cool because it's a great opportunity to get a lot of vehicles that are driving around all day converted over to electric. The interior of the E-Transit looks very similar if you've ever seen a regular Transit. This one, and of course all the E-Transits, are going to have the large sync screen, and that's for, you know, managing the charging, navigation, and other, you know, normal functions. If you're familiar with the Mach-E, if you looked at it in our videos, it's going to function basically the same. It's going to have the same sync software. And the sync software, of course, will play a role in connectivity to the fleet management software. I should note that we didn't get a detailed look inside the interior of the F-150 Lightning, but it'll be just like the regular F-150 and have a lot of the same features. And of course, you're going to have the big sync screen in there as well. One of the features that they really wanted to highlight on the E-Transit is that the rear cargo area is exactly the same as the current Transit. What that means for fleet operators is that a lot of the aftermarket rack systems and gear that you would put in a regular Transit are completely compatible with the E-Transit. We did get a quick peek under the hood of the E-Transit. There's no frunk on the E-Transit. You can see the HVAC and the cooling systems are all up in the front of the E-Transit, but no frunk. And then to wrap up the day, it was the moment that we all look forward to. We actually got to ride in each of these vehicles. Unfortunately, Ford asked us not to film inside the vehicles, but we did get a chance to ride in the F-150 Lightning, the E-Transit, and the F-150 Lightning while it was towing. I got a little bit of footage from the outside, but of course I was hopping in and out of vehicles getting my ride. But I can tell you this, the F-150 Lightning is amazingly fast. I have the Mach-E first edition that does 0 to 60 in about 4.8 seconds. This felt faster. I believe they're shooting for like mid 4 seconds for the 0 to 60 times, which of course nobody, you know, really cares about in trucks for the most part, or most people don't, I should say, but it was quick. And then the second part was, as you can see in the video, like we took off and then we did sort of like a mini autocross in the F-150 Lightning. And that was just sort of mind blowing. It was amazing how well this thing handled. My mind really couldn't even sort of compute, like we were in a heavy truck and taking corners like you wouldn't believe. It was awesome to be in. As I said, we did hop out and hop back into the other vehicles. I'll just say, like, while it was towing, the F-150 Lightning was still very quick. The E-Transit was probably the least exciting to ride in, but it was still pretty cool. Took off fairly quickly, probably faster than any current regular Transit, so it was pretty impressive. We didn't like super, you know, autocross in the thing, but they did demonstrate, you know, taking a very hard stop in the E-Transit. And like I mentioned, a voice from the sync system spoke to us and said that harsh braking isn't good for efficiency or safety, and that it should only be done during emergency conditions. And of course that's, you know, that could be turned on or off by the fleet manager, but I thought it was like a really cool feature and lets the driver know that that's being reported back to the fleet manager somewhere. So that's it about the event. It was very cool. If you get a chance, I encourage you to take a look at either of these vehicles. Both of them are really cool to ride in. The excitement is building for both of these vehicles. The E-Transit they just announced is sort of like rolling out like in the test phase. So they're actually getting these to some customers so they can test them out before they ramp up the full production. It's also been reported that the E-Transit is sold out. I'm guessing they mean sold out maybe for the first year of production. The last I heard, they have about 25,000 orders for the E-Transit. And just to reference that, they make about 130,000 regular Transits per year. They are just now making the pre-production models for the F-150 Lightning. And what that means is they're making them on the assembly line and then going out and testing and making sure everything's working as it's supposed to. They're expecting the first deliveries of the F-150 Lightning to customers to come in mid-2022. And in the first year, they're hoping to get about 15,000 of those delivered to customers. In 2023, they're hoping to deliver about 55,000, and then the next year, 80,000. Those numbers have been increased from their initial estimates, and part of that is because they have 160,000 reservations for the F-150 Lightning already. So what do you guys think? Are you excited for the F-150 Lightning and the E-Transit, or one or both? Anyways, that's all I have for now. Hope to see you again on other videos. I'm covering a lot of Mach-E stuff if you're not familiar with the channel, but we cover other EVs, not just from Ford, but from any manufacturer as well. So if you haven't, please subscribe, stick around, and enjoy some more EV content. Have a great day.